analyzes the sentence. If we analyzes the sentence, we can divide the sentence into two parts. First part is rabbits live in burrows. And next part is eat. And they eat fresh carrots. There are two parts. Dear students, here two words are confusing words, rabbits and burrows. Can anyone tell me what is the meaning of rabbits? Rabbits is a name of animals. You can compare it to hare. I can say it in Bangla. This is khargosh. Hare, rabbits. But there is a little difference between rabbits and hare. Rabbits in a small in size than hare. Khargosher chey rabbits kichuta akare choto. This is the difference. And another word, burrows. Burrows is a place. Burrows is a tunnel. Burrows is a hole dug by the small animals, especially rabbits. মানে র‍্যাবিটসরা খরগোশরা যে গর্তে অ্যাজ ডোয়েলিং প্লেস তাদের বসবাসের জন্য যে গর্তে থাকে সেটাই হচ্ছে বারোস. দিস ইজ বারোস. অ্যানাদার ওয়ার্ড ইজ ক্যারোটস. দিস ইজ ওয়ান কাইন্ড অফ ভেজিটেবল, ওয়ান কাইন্ড অফ ফ্রুটস. দেন ডিয়ার স্টুডেন্টস, নাও অ্যানালাইজ দ্য সেন্টেন্স. তাহলে দিস ইজ টু পার্টস, র‍্যাবিটস লিভ ইন বারোস, অ্যানাদার পার্ট ইজ দে ইট ফ্রেশ ক্যারোটস. And these two sentences, two parts are joining with and. Here we can see the and is a joining words and connecting words. So when a word joining two sentences, two words or two phrases, we call it conjunction. So here and is conjunction. Next, we can ask the sentences like who live in burrows. What is the answer? Who live in burrows? Rabbits live in burrows. The answer is rabbits. Here the rabbits is the name of animal. Hence the rabbits here, rabbits is noun. Next, if we ask where do rabbits live, rabbit kuthay bas kor. The answer is rabbit live in burrows. Rabbits live in burrows. Here burrows is a name of place. Hence the place is also a noun. So here burrows is also a noun. Next, what do they means rabbits. Rabbits eat. What do they eat? Turkey khai. The answer is rabbits eat carrots. The answer is carrots. This is the name of food. Because the name of food, it is also a noun. Now, dear students, we can see there are three nouns in the sentences. Rabbits, name of animals. Burrows, name of place. Carrots, name of food. Number four, if I ask Who eats the Tara? Who eats rabbits? Who eats carrots? Who eats carrots? कारा कैरोट खाए, के कैरोट खाए, ताले दिस इज द आंसर, दे ईट कैरोट्स, द आंसर इज दे ईट कैरोट्स, दे इज रिफरिंग टू रैबिट्स, हियर दे इज रिफरिंग टू रैबिट्स, रैबिट्स इज द नाउन, दोज वर्ड्स रिफरिंग टू नाउन, वी कॉल इट प्रोनाउन, वी कॉल इट प्रोनाउन, हेंस द वर्ड दे इज कॉल्ड pronoun. Number 5, what kind of carrot, what kind of carrots they eat, ki dhoroner khabar tara khay, ki dhoroner khabar, what kind of, ki dhoroner khabar khay, they eat fresh carrots, they eat fresh carrots. Here, fresh. Place before noun. Place before noun. And we know the words before noun is always adjective. The word before nouns is always adjective. Hence, the word fresh is adjective. Fresh is adjective. Next, number 6, what do they do, tara ki kore, what do, tara ki kore, they live in barrows, and another they live in barrows and they eat fresh carrots. Here two actions, we can see two actions with the words live and eat, and we know these words shows actions is called verb. These words shows action, like here live is action, and hence this is verb, and also the word it is action, it shows an action, so this word it also a verb. Now dear students, number 7, if I say how often do they eat, how often do they eat? I said Bangla, tara koto bar khay, koto shomoy dhore khay, ba koto tuku khay, ba koto bar khay, tale the answer is daily, the answer is daily, protidin khay, koto bar khay, protidin, daily, here daily referring to eats, and we know the word, when the word modifying verbs, when these words, those words modifying verbs is called adverb. Hence their daily is here adverb, daily is here adverb. Now in this sentence, in is placed before noun, in is placed before noun, and is referring, is showing relationship with live. Rabbits live in burrows, the burrows are, and live, this is the relationship, somporko toiri korche in diye. We know those words makes relationship before noun, and other words is called preposition, is called preposition, it's called preposition. Now, dear students, we have the left well. The what? Well. Here, well is short. Well is short exclamation. Short exclamation. Exclamation or feelings. Or feelings. When the word shows feelings or short exclamation, we call it interjection. We call it interjection. Interjection is the short words like wow, like well, like alas, like hooray. This is all our interjection. Now the action, look at the board. We have got the 8 parts of speech here. This is rabbits, barrows, carrots. All these 3 words are noun. Why is it noun? Because this is name of animal. Name of animal. This is name of place. And the rest of the word, name of food. And we know name of animal, name of place, and name of food. All are noun. তাহলে আমরা নাউন বলতে কি বলতে পারি? যে নাউন ইজ এ নেমিং ওয়ার্ডস. হোয়াট ইজ নাউন? নাউন ইজ এ নেমিং ওয়ার্ডস. নেম অফ অ্যানিমালস, নেম অফ প্লেস, নেম অফ ফুড, নেম অফ আইডিয়া অলসো. দিস ইজ নাউন. অ্যান্ড নেক্সট হিয়ার ইজ দ্য ওয়ার্ড দে. দে ইজ প্রোনাউন. They is pronoun. This is replacing what? In place of noun. Pronoun stands in place of noun. Noun এর পরিবর্তে pronoun বস. Here I, we, you, he, she, they. All these are pronouns. Now we have got 8 Dear students, we have got 8 kinds of parts of speech. Number one, noun. Yes. Number 2, pronoun. Pronoun. Number 3, adjective. Pronunciation is adjective. D is silent here. D is silent here. D এর উচ্চারণ এখানে হবে না. This is adjective. Next, adverb. Adverb. Now, this we also know adverb. মানে add করছে, মানে যোগ করছে, মানে verb সম্পর্কে অতিরিক্ত তথ্য দেয়া. এই হচ্ছে adverb. Tip preposition. Correct pronunciation is preposition, not preposition. Conjunction. Conjunction is connecting word, joining word. Connect two words, two phrases, two sentences also. Next one is verb. This is action words. This is shows action. These words shows action is called verb. And last one is interjection. Last one is interjection. Now, dear students, we have learnt about the 8 kinds of parts of speech, and now we have to summarize it. What is the noun? Noun, name of place, name of things, name of animals, name of foods, etc. Pronoun stands in place of noun. In place of noun. Noun এর পরিবর্তে বসে. Noun এর পরিবর্তে. Yesterday I learned, the day before yesterday I learned about the noun and pronoun, the function of noun and pronoun. সেখানে আমি বলেছিলাম নাউন যে যে কাজ করে প্রোনাউন সেই সেই কাজ করে একটা নাউন সেন্টেন্সে সাবজেক্ট অবজেক্ট হিসেবে কাজ করে প্রোনাউনও সাবজেক্ট অবজেক্ট হিসেবে কাজ করে মাইন্ড ইট দেন অ্যাডজেক্টিভ অ্যাডজেক্টিভ ডিসক্রাইবস ডিসক্রাইবস নাউন অ্যাডভার্ব ডিসক্রাইবস ভার্ব প্রিপোজিশন এটা দিস শোয়িং রিলেশনশিপ 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 টু আদার ওয়ার্ডস আদার ওয়ার্ডস আদার ওয়ার্ডস কনজাংশন ইজ এ জয়নিং ওয়ার্ডস ইজ ইজ জয়নিং জয়নিং ওয়ার্ডস or connecting words connecting connecting words verb shows action and last one is interjection interjection short exclamation exclamation or feelings or feelings. Now dear students, what did we know today? We know the 8 kinds of parts of speech and their definition. And now dear students, I will give you before the homework one action is left. In English words, many words are, can have more function, more job in a sentence. More job, একটা ওয়ার্ডে বিভিন্ন কাজ আছে. Suppose, someone asks you, some person, what is the parts of speech of water? Suppose water. You can say it, the water is the name of element. So this is noun. This is not the correct answer. This is not the correct answer. Because parts of speech stands in a sentence and plays a vital role, plays a function and uses. Many kinds of parts of speech are used as water. Such as look at the board. If I say water, water is essential to our life. Pani hocche amader jiboner jonno attyaboshok, proyojonio, necessary. Word. Next word, I water the plants. I water the plants every day. Every day. And last one is we are excited to see see different color of water bubbles. This is water bubbles. Now there's a look at the board. Now analyze the sentences. There are three sentences here. And we can see the word water first in the sentence, the water stands at the very beginning of the sentence. Then number two, water stands after the subject. water stands after the subject. And number three sentences, water stands before noun. Here's bubble is noun. And we know when a word is placed very beginning of a sentence and works as subject, we call it noun. So here water is noun. But in number two sentence, we can see water is stands after the subject. So here water is not noun. Here water shows action. So it is verb. So it is verb. And number three, here this is noun, and we know those words stands before noun is adjective, called adjective. So we can see the same words are placed in a sentence and place a different parts of pieces. Dear sense, now I will give you some homework. Are you ready? Please take down what we write on the board. Number one, work is find out the underlined sentences, underline sentences and identify what parts of speech the word play. Number one, I bought a beautiful dress. I bought a beautiful dress. Beautiful, underline the word beautiful. Next, number two, you have to write down in your khata. Number two, what did she ask to do? To do. Yes, she. Number three, I left my shoes under the kitchen. Number four, if we finish our work quickly, if we finish our work quickly, we can go home. Number five, on Fridays I work in the garden. Or number six, I want to go to a university in Dhaka. Number seven, so this is your homework. डियर स्टूडेंट प्लीज सबमिट द होमवर्क नेक्स्ट क्लास एंड योर टास्क इज टू फाइंड आउट द आइडेंटिफाई द अंडरलाइन वर्ड्स what kind of parts of speech there. One is done by me. I bought a beautiful dress. Here beautiful, this is noun, dress is noun, and the word noun er age je word ta boshe, this is adjective. One is done for rest of the words you have to done to your khata. So dear students, that's all for today. Take care and please stay with us. And show you, see you the next class. Thank you, dear students.